products wise, what I do whilst I'm in the shower, what I do after when I'm out of the shower. That made no sense what I did after the shower. You get the hint of looking after my skin, teeth, all that sort of stuff. First things first, electric toothbrush, come on. You should be using an electric toothbrush compared to a traditional sort of toothbrush. I think the difference is quite drastic, if I'm honest with you. When I'm in the shower, what I wash my beard and hair with, the Dove 2-in-1 shampoo and conditioner. I know some twats are gonna come and go, hang on, George, you can't be doing that because the chemicals in 3.5, 7.5 degree and angle will make your hair go thinner and then you will lose your hair. Some shit like that, someone will tell me. It does the job. I keep it in there for a couple of minutes. My hair's still here, my beard is probably better than the person that's fucking said that anyway. It's all down to genetics at the end of the day. That's the one I use, very easy. I don't shampoo, then put conditioner. I ain't got time for that. What I do in the shower as well is exfoliate. So I get myself a sponge. As you can see, there's a bit of a dirty sponge as I've just exfoliated my skin. Don't get me, nitty boy. Not a nitty boy, I've just exfoliated my face. Thank you very much. Use in terms of exfoliation scrub. It's actually the one that my sister uses, and I actually stole it off her, and ever since I've been using it, it's great. It's the Scent Ivy's Blemish Control. As you can see there, it focuses, there we go. Like using this, I basically obviously wet my face, squirt it onto the sponge, exfoliate my face. I normally use gloves, like you might have seen me use gloves before, and just exfoliate my skin like this. Do my face probably every other day, just because my pores are quite open. You probably can't tell in the video, but I've got quite open pores. I gain quite a lot of blackheads around my nose, around here. So it's really important just to exfoliate that, keep on top of it. Then I will exfoliate my body pretty much 2-3 times a week. At the moment, I'm getting sunbeds. So it's really important for me to actually look after my skin as well. A nose trimmer. So I don't know why, but ever since I've gone like 22, 23 now, my nostril hairs keep poking out. So a nose trimmer for men is really, really important. There's nothing worse than having fucking hair poking out your nose. You've seen the old people have got like loads of hair sticking out their fucking nose and their ears. It's butters. And I'm thinking, when I'm that age, I am not doing that. There's no way in hell I'm walking around with fucking hair poking out my ears. Fuck me. Anyway, enough swearing, George, it's too much. I also shave. I'll show my shavers once I've done this video, but what I do immediately when I come out of the shower, I obviously shave around my penis area, I'll be very honest, and I sweat a lot around there. So what happens is I build up sometimes, not all the time, but I actually build up little sweat glands, little spots, they're like lumps that come up to the skin. Quite uncomfortable. You literally can burst them with like a fucking needle if you really wanted to. So what I do now every day to prevent doing that is the good old fashioned pseudo cream. You can't go wrong with pseudo cream. Antiseptic. Gets rid of them in the next fucking couple of days. That's really important. If you shave, like me, I shave my legs, I shave my whole entire body, as you can probably see. The only fucking face that, bruv, what am I saying? The only thing I don't shave is this fucking on my chinny chin chin. This is a must in order for you to prevent the sweat glands from building up and making it really uncomfortable. Sometimes I've left it and I'm walking like this, rubbing against the old ball sack. Not good. And obviously I sweat a lot down there through training. Wow, 3 minutes, 40 fucking 5 seconds. Okay, cool, that's the first part. When it comes to beard oils and things like that, I used myself a comb, got myself a beard oil. Lemon sherbet flavour from Alpha Beards. I actually don't know if this company's still going. Don't take my word for it. If you do search them up and go, hey George, they're not live anymore. They haven't responded to me in 6 months. Probably because they're not active, mate. If you haven't got any beard oil, use some olive oil. Use some coconut oil as well. Works really well. So what I'm going to do, I squirt that on here. I'll even fucking show you as I'm wearing. Bit of dab on there. Cack-handed. And I just literally brush it through, get myself a comb, and of course, get myself a comb. What am I talking about, Becca? Get myself a comb. Got myself a comb already, aren't you, twat? And then brush it through as always. And you could probably smell that. Can you smell it from here?
Yeah.
You can't, can you?
Yeah, I can. Can you? I actually can.
I thought you were lying to me.
What's it, like peppermint?
No, it's lemon sherbet, you fucking idiot. I just said lemon sherbet. Hello, my sister, she's a fucking retard.
Oh, yeah, it does smell like lemon, actually. Yeah, it's lemon. Okay, yeah.
What did you say it was?
Peppermint.
Peppermint, fuck me. You got COVID. Lost your smell of you or something. Jesus Christ, man. Hair-wise, I use this white powder stuff that I just literally sprinkle on my head. Sometimes what I do is I sprinkle it on my head like this, and I move my head, and I start choking like nobody's business because it goes in my mouth and stuff. So as you can see there, and it basically just like sits, it makes your hair sit. So I like a bit of a messy top at the moment. It helps your hair stay in one place. So that is from, where's that from? Uppercut Deluxe, a bit of a manly sort of brand, even though they've got a female on there. I bet back in the day they just had two men fighting, because obviously now people are like, oh, it's like Yorkie bars, isn't it? They've had to put a female in there. You seen that? It's quite good. What would you call that? Quite good.
Graphic design?
Graphic design. In terms of moisturiser, I use a double base gel. This is actually my mum's. I don't actually use my own. I used to use cocoa butter. Cocoa butter? Coconut oil butter. Palmer's, whatever it's called. I use this now instead because my skin is quite dry from using the sunbed sometime. And this is double coat, so this will help protect your skin, look after your skin. And as you can see, in terms of shavers, OG know the shavers. Pink Lady Shaver. Absolute goat for the past like 2 years for me. 20 quid off Amazon. Yes, it's females. Yes, it's pink. Who gives a fuck? It's 2021. However, Mr. AJ Morris, if you're watching this, you've made me convert to the One Blade. Apparently, this is the best shaver he's used. So I'll take his word for it. Haven't even used it yet. So what I will do with this, when I do use it, is just trim up the edges, because obviously I grow hair up here, 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 a little bit here, and just do between the eyebrows as well. I'll have to give a full review of that in the next video. But as you can see, it's got like a little, it's got like little components and stuff. You know, I don't know, different lengths. And that's pretty much it. This is the hairdryer that I used. It's not even mine. It's called, I don't know, is this a good hairdryer, Becca?
I guess hairdryer's a hairdryer, isn't it?
It is, hairdryer's a hairdryer at the end of the day. And that is fucking it. That's how I look as sexy as what I fucking do.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. We are live with this to voiceover today with George Edward Osborne, the king, the master, the OG of YouTube. I don't know why I started that off, but we're just going to keep it going. Fuck the audio up on this video. External mic just didn't want to work. So this is a voiceover in this segment of the video. So I hope you've enjoyed today's video so far. I hope you got some tips from the old grooming segment. Probably not ladies. If you're watching this still, ladies, fucking fair play to you. Fair play to you. You must really like me. And if you're not, and if you've turned off and then you've came back, fuck you, yeah? Anyway, welcome to the voiceover. As always, we're going to provide some value and we're also going to provide some entertainment, the best of both worlds, in my opinion. Push on the car today. Second rotation of the week, which is my shoulder. I would say it's shoulder based, but the only real shoulder based areas is at the beginning of the session. Starting off with cuff lateral raises, one of my favorite exercises. I'm using 1RM cuffs from Josh. Shout out Josh. And what I really think about with these, especially that top set, is one thing you might notice already is I'm keeping my arms straight. I like to keep my arms straight because I got this from Nick Gloff actually, so all my side lateral raises are basically straight arms, just so I can avoid it using any sort of momentum, let my traps dominate. What I'm really trying to think about here is leaning through the elbows, aiming for the corners of each room. So obviously you can't see the corners of the room right now, but that's kind of what I'm trying to do. And at the end, what I do is I try and get 10 partials. Now, if you saw me doing this in gym, you think, you fucking idiot, what are you doing? But honestly, at the end of a set, when you're already frazzled from the actual set itself, the lactic acid buildup you get is you're cream crackered. The dumbbells at this gym, yeah, this is just an excuse for me, really. Dumbbells at the gym are extremely hard. So getting used to doing a high incline double press again for me is going to take some time, just relearning that movement pattern. I haven't done it for ages. And I'm 20 pounds down. And I think ever since I've obviously came back from my illness, shout out everyone supporting me on that, by the way. I think my pressing movements have taken a big chunk. My leg movements aren't too bad, but my pressing, obviously being 20 pounds down, has dropped quite significantly. But the first week I gained back about 2.5 pounds. So I'm on the way back up, let's say. I think what I did better in this back off set is I flicked both the dumbbells up at the same time. The first set, I think I edited it out, but what I did was I struggled to actually get the first rep up because I spent so much time actually kicking the dumbbells back. Whereas with this back off set, what I literally did is I just chucked both up and it made it much easier. And I literally like doubled the reps with like 2, 5, or 5 kilos down, I think it was, which don't normally happen with me. What I'm showing here is basically I'm using the incline prime press, and always the first rep is extremely hard to get up. But what I did is I got some ropes. I attached it to where the machine hits the bottom, just to make that first rep slightly easier for me to get up, because I haven't got a spot, when you're on your own, make your life easier when it comes to that first rep, because you can probably get 2-3 more reps out by just having a spotter, right? So just make your life a little bit easier. This is one of my favorite movements for chest. I haven't done this in about 6 to 8 months. So I had 225 plates each side, which is not strong at all for this, but I'm very confident now I'm able to add probably 10 kilos to this in a space of like 2 weeks. Moving really nicely. Calves look all right there, boy. Come on, Georgie boy. Shave the legs as well. So looking fresh as a daisy. Got into the groove with the back off sets. I try and make them as continuous as I can. But as always, taking it to failure, control, intent, purpose, not leaving anything in the tank. You know, that's what the Georgie boy does. That's something I promote because it's fun. I like that style of training. So that was 2 sets on that. 1 set of 5 to 9, 1 set of 10 to 12, normally on a compound movement like that. Then we move on to the bread and butter, the dips, the gold standard. I've always said, if you want big fucking arms, people spend so much time doing tricep press downs, all this. And don't get me wrong, they serve a purpose, but they forget about getting strong on these sort of things. So I've always said, look at someone who's dipping 100 kilos, 80 kilos between their legs. They're not going to be fucking small, are they? You know, unless you are a genetic weirdo that can do that, which there are, by the way. There's some genetic freaks about that can do that sort of shit. But for me, you get strong at this sort of stuff, you're going to see some nice development in your arm. So my back offset, as you can see here, I just had a 20 plate between my legs and I was just kind of repping out as much as I could. I've noticed in this first week, especially, I hit a fucking wall very, very quickly with fatigue. So I think going into this new week, second week back into the gym, I'm going to really improve the endurance, the fatigue management side of things just by being back in the gym and training. Now, this is the first ever time I've done like an incline cuffed fly. Actually, funny enough, look at me bumming Josh Bridgman again, using his cuffs and actually copying an exercise that I've seen him do. He's got a great chest and I'm thinking, why can't I be a natty version of Josh Bridgman, which is never going to happen. So I thought I'd give this a go. I need to play around with my alignment. As you can see, my elbows are coming a little bit too far back there. What I should have done is I should have brought my elbows slightly forward and just kept it into one smooth pattern, because as you can see, I'm opening up my sort of chest there, which isn't a bad thing. I still felt it. But obviously filming yourself is, when you do a new exercise, yeah, make sure you fucking film it, regardless of if you're sending it to your coach or whether you're looking at it yourself, because we all visualize what it looks like in our head, right? And then when we watch it back, 9 times out of 10, it's completely fucking different. Hence why I always record, because I learn so much about me and how I move in the gym and how I take things to failure, this and that. It's really important, especially if you're a beginner. And always people say, oh, I'm not confident at filming myself in the gym. And I get that. I appreciate and understand that. But at the same time, like, fuck me, no one cares. Like, no one goes home and goes, oh, do you remember George that was doing the incline cuff fly? Oh, my God, what was he? No one goes home and thinks about that. No one actually cares. It's just a lot of the time in your head. So then we move on to the side lateral raise. So record yourself. Motto of that, what I just said, record yourself and don't be a fucking pussy about it. Man up a bit. I can't say that. 2021, George, we can't man up nowadays, because men can cry and they can cry, but we can also man up, and ladies can woman up. That was dead. Side lateral raises. Again, keeping those arms nice and straight, really focusing just all the tension on the side delts. Movements like this, you don't need to be moving weight from A to B. Just focus on just building up some metabolic stress within those side delts. I think they will respond really, really well. Then went on to some tricep isolation stuff to finish the session. I did a tricep press down with this like assist your gym pin sort of attachment, which I applied some D handles to. And as you can see, it looks really, really good. And it's really smooth as well to use. So I finally, I'm looking at that guy there. Fucking focus on the exercise, Georgie boy, come on. So yeah, loving the Vans, by the way. As you can see, the Vans and the Nike socks going really, really well, making the calf stand out. So obviously I did a tricep press down for the short head, and then I did an overhead sort of incline skull crush. I actually did these with Brandon Harding once, and fuck me, my triceps were frazzled afterwards, as I've said already. Really good. If you want big, thick triceps as well, a lot of people just do loads of tricep press downs. Focus on doing some overhead presses for the long, meaty portion of that tricep. What I typically like to say with these, and you probably saw it in the previous clip, is keep that elbow in a fixed position. Too many people moving about on this particular movement. Stay in a fixed position. You'll notice a big difference. And I like to add a little pause at the bottom just to ensure that I am, really, really overloading that short-term range. And then again, just some posing post-workout, 1 week back into the gym. I've gained some fullness. I'm still flat across like the chest, I'm noticing. Some areas are taking a little bit longer to fill out. But in terms of where I'm at, 1 week back into the gym, I'm quite happy. And you could probably see the difference from my previous video when I uploaded my physique update compared to where I am now. Obviously, the lighting's a little bit different, but I'm gaining back that fullness.
Oh, it's a hot one, isn't it? Comment down below, Pink Lady Apple, or just Apple. If you're not a fan of Pink Lady Apples, just comment down below, Apple. If you are a fan of Pink Lady Apples, comment down below, Pink Lady. God knows, when people scroll through that and they haven't watched the full video, they think, why are people commenting this sort of stuff? If this video has helped at all, which I very much doubt it has, drop a like. Subscribe if you are new around here. If you just watch me and you go, I like this guy, he's pretty sound, drop a like and subscribe, I should say. Lots of love, and I'll see you guys in the next one.
Bro break down like discos, but I'm a distro just like Tommy. Let's get it. I just got a half a box and I rid in a week, that's a test like Johnny. Okay. He said that his line does blow and I got bare drills, so I do that Connie. But if he takes over the deadline, after that he won't get none from me. Drought time when there's only a fours, I got a draws that Z by Z. And if there's a need.